Operational report. Submarine are detected. Awaiting loading. Oh, crud. Flooding on the landing craft infantry. Ah, useless. Repairs complete. Awaiting loading. Awaiting loading. Hits. Kill credit. Kill credit. Kill credit. Detections. Crash. Supplies moved. Infantry moved. Repairs complete. Kagoshima captured. Expansion. Aircraft in the pipeline. Reinforcement, San Francisco. Checking for collisions. No collisions. Damaged submarines? Not so many now, huh? We're down to one list. Is that because they're mostly sunk? Uh-oh, Pomfrey took a beating. Yeah, come on home. Capitaine creeping into Naha. Looks like all the damaged boats are coming back. Checking on endurance. Looks like Rasher. Oh, already back. Pito. We'll come back now. And I think Shad will probably... Yeah, Shad already is on her way back. Good. Nago, repairs continuing. At least we're out of the red, I think. I think they're all out of the red now. Over at... Naha, Tenosa. Menhaden is trying to get... Tenosa is trying to get ready for sea. No changes here. Okay, a couple of these. Hado and Flounder. It's Cabrilla and Mapiro are much more badly damaged. So Flounder and Hado, I think, are going to come out. And we'll put the other two in. Oh, no. Hado cannot come out because she can't do any repairs inside. Neither can Flounder. Okay. So neither of these can come out. They have to go. They have to stay in. The only way to get them there. All right. Let's take a look at Manila. Oh, 12 boats in. Two more ready to go. We have 106 ships under repair right now. Better than, well, it was 300. I guess some of them got repaired. Some of them I just put back into service. I'm using them even though I can't. Even though they're slightly damaged. All right, I'm looking at these transports here, and guess what? Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, I'm stupid. Guess what? Here I am thinking, oh yeah, I'm going to load up this. Oh, not this one. Which one is it now? The combat engineers. Not combat engineers here. The artillery. And I was going to, which one? Here it is, 316. I thought, oh yeah, I'm going to fill up my armored. I'm going to pick up the rest of the armored. So like an idiot, I told it to fill up supplies. I think they said we had 800% overage. So I said, okay, well, she obviously, I can fill up some supply, right? Fool me twice, I'm an idiot. So what does it do? Fills up 5,700 supply points and takes 5 trucks. Are you freaking kidding me? This stupidity here. 5 each. I need 8 transports to fill up this last one? Oh, stupid. Now, it's not so bad. See, I said that some of these units I was going to set just load only troops, no supplies, and this seems to be okay. Some of them seem to have actually worked, filled up totally. Then there's the other ones that where I thought I could cheat and get some supplies on it. I don't think it worked. This one, 10th Army. Sure enough, we leave 215 or whatever, however many, 200 on the base, when I could have just 4,000 supplies points here. Instead of, so we take 5 trucks and we leave the rest behind. Oh, am I stupid? Why do I keep thinking that the game is ever going to be any better than this? Thank God I've got 1 million transports here to fill. But the whole point is, these filled. And there were a couple. There's a couple here that actually, I think I did tell it to fill both. And it was okay. It loaded the troops. Was it this one? Maybe. It loaded the troops and then filled up the supplies. Like it should. Like it should. Anyway, here goes another few hours making up, reloading each and every mother-loving unit here, one at a time! Like all this artillery. They took all the anti-aircraft guns and left all the artillery behind. Are you stupid or what? Right? They took a couple of howitzers, but they took all the anti-aircraft guns, every single piece of artillery left behind. Trucks, everything. Oh, am I stupid for believing in this game? All right, Singapore. We're getting a few Dauntlesses in here. Here comes the retrieval convoy, and we're all packed up, ready to go. Yeah, one more turn. By the time they arrive, we are ready to go. Nothing. Going to try to load again. We have a bunch more transports all loading on different units individually, and I'm only setting them to load ground troops only. So if they fill them up, then we can load some supplies next turn. So still going after it. We've got a few more fragmented infantry. That's pretty much it. I think we've gotten the rest of it. And trying to get as many of these engineers up as possible. In general, I'm going after the base forces. We got 75 ships trying to load these base forces. They don't have any engineers or radar. They're I guess ground post, ground guards more than anything else. So we're trying to load all these Air Force base forces. We're and the rest of these British base force, as well as the artillery. Most of the subs have, I think all the ships have refueled, and there's still a couple of tankers here unloading, but that's about, what, 120,000, 125,000. Amazingly, we sucked out all the fuel, pretty much all the fuel from the AOs as well. So having them here worked out, having them there, they did supplement the base. We took down, close to over to 600,000 fuel points just to send everybody up and back, plus all the fuel from the tankers, plus all the fuel from the AOs. So probably used up 1 million in that operation. Now I'm moving some aviation base forces up to Apari, ready to fly them over. If they're just support squads, I think I'm going to fly them rather than use ships to bring them up. Ships are riskier. Our next operation is going to have, where's fast transport? What, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, that's what, 200? 200, 200, 400, 5, maybe 500 some odd transports to take them up. We're still slamming supplies into Baton Island. Well, it's getting up there. Maybe we'll be finished. The AI seems to be less aggressive towards it. Maybe because of all, it's trying to bring reinforcements or bring some of the aircraft back, attention back to Kanoya. Okinawa. Okay, let's talk about Kanoya. We've taken Kagoshima. Woohoo! I will turn off the repairs for the resources. We don't need that. But, I've got all these points up here. I'm going to repair the shipyard for sure. And I'm going to... the light industry? Why not? We're just burning supply up here. We still are overstocked. 868,000, and we can only hold a 200,000 limit. So we're still wasting like a son of a gun. But a lot of that, look at what happened. Look how much got drawn up here. Really? 200,000? Okay. We're going to turn this on. Suck it up here, because there is no spoilage. Notice there's no maximum here. We're also going to build these suckers, build the airfield, build the port. Get it up to a... We can't... Oh, crap. It's only at 8.8 is maximum. Can you believe that? The next port that we... Fuel that we take can build up to a 9. That's Kumamoto. But we have to take it first. Look at this little pip over here. Hey, the AI's sending reinforcement. He's sending something down to try to take out my tanks. To throw them out of Kagoshima. Kumamoto. But Kumamoto is clear terrain, so there's no defensive modifiers here. But he's sending whatever he's sending. How's he gonna match 2,900 tanks? This is my full armored fist. So if the AI thinks that he can evict us, well, give it a good try. Give it a good try. But we've got all the armor here, and these anti-tank units. Well, these are kind of beaten up, right? They're kind of in bad shape. But these are tank destroyer battalions, and against the Japanese tanks, they should be able to cut through them like a hot knife through butter. But even without them, we still have the main tank units here, all waiting for the enemy. Let's take a look at there's nothing here. There's been a little bit of bombardment, and that's it. Heck, you know, I could probably put all of them into... I'm going to put all of them into reserve mode. Yeah, put them all in. Let's see if we can't recover a little more. I don't think they're penalized off of this in an artillery bombardment. If worse comes to worse, they just jump. If they get attacked, the AI will just bump into one of these guys. So it gives us a chance to recover anything that might be... Oh, they're all in the 100%. Look at that. There's a tank missing here. A couple of tanks missing here. But other than that, we're in very, very good shape. Okay, Kagoshima. We've taken it. We've got a base force on here. We've got 90 aviation support. Now, we're building. We've got a gazillion. About 20. This is about 450. So 450, 2,300, 2,200 worth of engineers on the base. Equivalent engineer squad. So I'm hoping we can get this up. The question in my mind is: Should I put fighters on top of it? Because if we put fighters on it, I only have 90 aviation support to defend right now. This is a failure on my part. Another failure on my part. I didn't move any of the aviation engineers. Why? Because I forgot. This base here is going. It will build up to a maximum of 7, so that the most we will ever need here is 350. Why did I keep 1,200 here? Because I'm stupid. So I need to move them up. We have 90 here, and they'll hold the line. But the other whatever few hundred, we can put up to 250 aircraft on here supposedly. You know, if I fly them in directly. They may not launch patrols the first day, and they're just going to get the crap bombed out of them on the ground. So, do I let the AI just bomb away? Oh, tough decision. Okay, I think I'm going to have to. I think I have to defend it. It just gives the enemy another target at which to shoot. We still have 23,000. We have to eliminate this unit here. So we've got the base force. We have to be in combat mode in order to. Have the radar functional. All the other units were in deliberate. We're in pretty good shape. Pretty good shape. A little bit high. Disruptions over 20, some of them. But that's just the price of doing business. We need to eliminate this guy as soon as possible in order to move on to Kumamoto. Yeah, these guys are holding the line. It would be real... shame if they got pushed out of the hex, but I don't see them. I don't see how any amount can push out 2,800 in tanks. So I'm pushing the aviation squads up. What I'm going to do is I've ordered all the squadrons here to fly at a range of one. So they'll cover our base and give a little bit of protection over the other one. The fatigue is going to be quite, it's going to be really, 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 like the fatigue here is already 33. Man, I don't think I'm going to, no, I'm going to hold this one back. The fatigue is too high on this one already. But the other, you guys, that's the, you're tough. Tough. You're just gonna have to fly over and protect them while they land. Okay, I'm going to be jumping some night fighters into the area. We've been getting a lot of raids, and since this is a ground base, we don't have to worry about size the way I'm always concerned about it on an island. There's less concern about size on the land than it is up than. Than on Iwo Jima or somewhere else like that. So I'm going to send these twin engine fighter bombers over. We've got bow fighters here. Ooh, we've got lots of bow fighters. There's 22 of them. Making sure I had some of them resting over here, where some of the low fatigue. There's 22 here. I think I'm going to send the mosquitoes. I like mosquitoes. They've got that radar on there, okay. Plus, I can add 10 aircraft right now, so I'm going to add all of them. I'm not going to add them with filling out the aircraft from here, because then if I use this button, they appear damaged and require repair before they can be used. Instead, I'm going to add them into the reserves. I can add up to 12. That way, they'll be ready to fly next turn. Let's go for night, and I'm going to order for a range of one. I don't expect them to fly next turn, but at least we'll get them up there. Let's see, can we get all the way to? No, we cannot. So we need some tanks. Transfer up to Kagoshima. We'll leave them at a range one so they can protect each other and they don't need to go much further. See, five are already damaged once they land. Got to make sure, every time we move things up there, got to make sure we backfill. Backfill is the term. Okay, we've got a couple of squadrons close by. This is already filled up what? One of the 10 groups possible, and we filled 58 of the 250 allowed. We have other squadrons here. We've had Thunderbolt squadron here, sitting here, resting, and, well, this is the fragment. So I think I'm going to jump this one in. Hopefully, because it's going to be a short hop over to Kagoshima, I'm hoping that the AI will let this one fly. I'll divide it. We're going to fly some at 10, one at 15, and another element at 20. Okay, that's another squadron. We've got Okinawa. Do we have any? We have another squadron here, another Thunderbolt squadron. We're going to fly these at 5. They've been resting. Okay, Kagoshima. I don't know what the AI is gonna what will be allowed. So we're at 231. I think I'm gonna leave it for now. I can always bring more later. But these squadrons, now there's space up here. We need to backfill with other squadrons so that we can bring them in later. And the transports continue to shuffle headquarters units to the front. Hajima, we're just about to finish unloading and sail away. Tanker coming in to drop some fuel here. I doubt we'll ever need it. Yeah, but better to have it than not have it. Southward, the convoys are moving back and forth, but there goes that light cruiser that survived. We sank one of them, and the other one escaped. Now these guys have taken damage, and they've used up all their most of their weapon, well, much of their weaponry, the heavy torpedoes and whatnot. One cruiser, Marblehead, is damaged and heading for Pagan. Now, I don't. Why are you heading for Pagan of all places? Also, the AI broke out a destroyer for escort, which is fine. But why would you send? Okay, she's making speed 20. Why the heck wouldn't you send this destroyer that's making speed 25? Whipple got hit somewhat badly. Out of ammo. Ah, crap. Okay, first things first. We were down here. Okay, we're chasing. Let's get. Where's the first one? Let's get up here. He's moving to the northeast. He's going into the convoy zone. Let's try this. Let's go right on top and then move over and try to intercept. I'm going to form up surface action group. We're sending this one. She's badly damaged enough. I'm sending her over to Pearl. Pearl Harbor will be a much bigger port, easy to fix. Lickety split. Same with these guys. We're going to set for Pearl. Gosh, why would you want? I suspect we could probably for, ooh, 25 major. Ooh, I wanted to send it back, but we have over 50% cumulative damage, or what do you call, aggregate damage, so the planes won't fly. Otherwise, I'd send it back to aid in the search effort. I'm going to break apart, form a surface action group. I'm going to break apart with the carrier's fort. Ooh, no. Where base is here? Let's see. If I bring, I don't want to. Okay, I'm going to set it back here. I'm really hoping this guy doesn't go into action because he'd be going into action alone. I would like to. No, let's keep it conservative. I would like to link up with this one, but if I order it to meet, if I use the meet command, meet and join command, it might slow these guys down. I want them to catch this guy instead. We the cruiser group still has some ammo, not much in the forward guns, but we can use the right side and the left side both engaged, so we at least have some capability. And the rear turret engaged. Wow, that was interesting. Here's the other destroyer group, cruiser group. He didn't get here in time. Okay, we'll set the first one here and the next one up here. I doubt we're going to be able to catch it, but if he retires this direction, we might get him. We might get him. Here come my transports heading back to Hilo. And the oiler's going in. Oh, they move. They okay. No need for full speed. Just go in, and I guess disband is probably the easiest, eh? Aircraft-wise, no. Oh, the Lancasters are heading out. Now, if he's heading to the northeast and trying to come through this convoy route. I'm a little, ooh, this guy, these guys are running and these guys are going up. So we've got a little bit of a space here. I'm going to transfer those other two ships in. They're all the same speed, so why not go together? But unfortunately, coming through here, we just might bump this guy. So I'm going to put in a waypoint. Let's back up. It's only time. We're not really worried. I don't think he has search planes functional. Otherwise, he could be intercepting us. Here's another one. If we run 1-2-3, 1-2-3, I'm going to change this waypoint. We'll go here and then turn around and come back. This one's far enough away. I think I'll be okay. If we go 1-2-3, 1-2-3, yeah, I'm going to gamble and let this guy just sail. I'm just being callous, aren't I? And we have another convoy group right behind that. A single cruiser getting into these 20 of these transports can cause a lot of damage. I'm also going to call up the cruisers. That's what you're here for, guys. I'm going to form up surface action, and we're sending them forth from we'll send the Algonquin, the Canadians as well. The Canadian, the Sioux, that's right. Let's go set patrol. Let's go straight out. We've got search planes working. So if he's just angling around and heading back for Japan, oh, come on, what'd you do, you dummies? Straight out would be here. Hopefully, we'll intercept and kill the thing. That was a pretty spectacular battle, wasn't it? Oh, okay. Well, we didn't sink. It doesn't look like we've got a claim for anything sunk. These are from Kagoshima and near Kochi. Kiso. One less cruiser to be concerned. That's a 101 aircraft destroyed for 13. 8-1. Pearl Harbor is quiet. We have the transports coming in for retrieval. At Los Angeles, loading more tankers. Another 100,000 ready to go. We'll break them out and backfill with empty tankers. At San Francisco, we have a fast transport group arrived. We'll disband and repair these guys. Wow. Wow. That's a lot of damage. Okay, let's load them anyway, even though they're damaged. So we'll be ready to go when they're fixed. The ships are just hanging back. We're waiting for the reinforcements. 2 days. 2 days. First, a pair of torpedoes. One hits a transport. Wahoo! We ran right over, right into a destroyer group, but that's all right. We have destroyers and cruisers screening the carriers and the transports. Kraken launches a full spread at a transport, sinking it. Segundo fires on a transport, miss. Dragonet fires and hits a transport. Halibut fires on the destroyer, miss. Blower fires two torpedoes, both strike the tanker. Look at all that traffic. Hackleback launches two torpedoes at a knot at the destroyer, miss. Ling fires two torpedoes into a transport. Kagoshima under attack at night, no defense. They got through it on the base. Kanoya under night attack. Francis, the Hellcats intercept. And we get one by flak. Night attack Kagoshima by Betty's. Baton Island under attack. 22 Hellcats are in. The Tsurugi. Tsurugi intercepted. One shot down. Segundo launches two torpedoes at the Seiran. Dace engages the troop transport. A fast destroyer transport. I don't know. Miss, I guess. Halibut fires torpedoes and sinks a transport. Muscalunga fires two torpedoes at another transport, but misses. Lionfish hit by an E-boat. Oh! The Trenton catches up with the Sakawa and engages. The Sawakazi is hit badly. Breaks off. Okay, we didn't sink it though. The blower fires two torpedoes at a destroyer. Miss. Grace attacks a task force near Nago. It's actually, Grace is a dive bomber that can carry torpedoes, I understand. Intercepted, nine shot down. Wow, just one morning attack. Okay, we're already into the afternoon phase. Marcus Island. Oh, look. Okay, looks like he's moving to the northwest now. So maybe my cruiser group. Oh, and there's another group out here. Son of a gun, moving to the northwest. Will my cruisers make it? Oh, my cruisers are giving chase. Hopefully they've seen them. Nope, but they're giving chase the wrong way. Hold on. No, they went straight out. Hahajima under attack. Nels. Six are destroyed. Hahajima under attack again. What the heck? Why are their corsairs intercepting? Thunderbolts and oh, long range. These are the long range combat air patrol. Oh, okay. So we help out and shoot down a bunch of Bettys. Multiple multi-axis attack against Kanoya. It's not a big raid, but we still lose a bomber. Lose a fighter. One for six. Another attack, Kanoya. 30, 40 aircraft hit. Two more shot down. Those blasted Georges. Two for 17. Kanoya under attack again. Willow. Another attack. 12-1. 18 bombers attack. We shoot down 10. Three damage. Wow. The Oscars did well. Kanoya under attack by dive bombers. Three shot down. Hey, if he wants to concentrate on Kanoya, that makes me happy. Why does he want Kanoya so badly? The combat engineers bombed by piggies. One destroyed. If he wants to let my planes land peacefully on Kagoshima, all the more good. Bombardment. Kumamoto. Oh, we take a couple of disabled, and we lose a tank, probably. Probably. Bombardment Kagoshima. One engineer destroyed. Deliberate attack. 15-1. Yeah. Two enemy units destroyed. Just grind them. Grind them. We take about 500 casualties, but we grind them down. It's got 23 units there. Come on, you're surrounded. Surrender, die, whatever. Lots of our. Oh, how come it says 2 days, but then you saw it? You saw it. It says 2 days, and all of a sudden they arrive today. What, they count the morning and the night as one day? Stupid.